Farmers who were arrested over a land dispute in the Philippines' Tarlac province urged the Justice Department to dismiss the prosecutor who handled the inquest proceeding of their cases. Nine farmers who are part of the so-called Tinang 83 filed an administrative complaint against Mila May Montefalco. They accused Montefalco of committing grave and serious misconduct for allegedly conducting the inquest proceedings in a discriminatory manner. Aside from seeking her dismissal from service, they also want Montefalco removed as acting provincial prosecutor of Tarlac and preventively suspended without pay while she is being investigated. Montefalco charged the farmers with illegal assembly and malicious mischief after they held a cultivation activity in a land they rightfully own. Both the illegal assembly and malicious mischief charges were later junked in court, but the farmers continue to face three more complaints.
Five former policemen are facing 40 years in prison after being found guilty of kidnapping. It was in 2019 when the ex-cops abducted a supposed drug suspect. They detained him in a police station in Pasay City and then demanded 100,000 pesos in exchange for his release. It turned out that the drug suspect's arrest was not recorded in the police blotter, and neither was he involved in any prior drug case. All of the five accused have earlier been dismissed from service after having been found guilty of the administrative charge of grave misconduct for committing robbery, graft, and violating the code of conduct and ethical standards for public officials and employees. The conviction of the five cops came at the tail end of a six-year drug war of former President Rodrigo Duterte and is one of the few convictions of police officers. More than 6,000 drug suspects have been killed in law enforcement operations, according to official figures. The regularity of arrests and by-bust operations conducted by law enforcers have been questioned on several occasions. Thanks for joining us. President Bongbong Marcos abolishes two government offices through his first executive order. Those are the Office of the Cabinet Secretary and the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission, the body established by his predecessor, Rodrigo Duterte, to investigate corruption allegations against presidential appointees. Marcos cited the need to streamline his office's official processes and procedures by abolishing duplicated and overlapping functions amid the ongoing health and fiscal crisis the country is facing. The PACC's functions will now be transferred to the Office of the Deputy Executive Secretary for Legal Affairs. As for the Office of the Cabinet Secretary, its secretariat will be placed under the control of the presidential management staff. While the EO dismantled two offices, it created the Office of the Presidential Advisor on Military and Police Affairs. Former PACC Chairman Diego Benhica, surprised by the move of President Marcos, Benhica cited the importance of the agency he used to head, saying their work under the Duterte administration led to increased revenues for government.
Sa DESLA na po nanggaling ang PACC. However, ang DESLA po is an office that is, it is the lawyer of the president po. Hindi lang po anti-corruption ang trabaho niyan. Yung mga external, internal, legal issues ng presidente, yan po ang sumasagot. Eh, ang laki-laki po ang kaso at issue ng corruption sa Pilipinas. Kaya po, create ang PACC. Kailangan kasi bibigyan mo ng enough tools, enough tao, ang mga tauhan mo at opisina kung gusto mong ma-deliver niyan yung trabaho gusto nila, kailangan. Pagka natambakan ng kaso na naman yan, ilalala po ang corruption kasi wala napaparasahan.
But now that the PACC is gone, Benhica hopes President Marcos will strengthen other anti-corruption agencies in government.
I agree with streamlining. Pero with peace and order issues, with drugs, crimes, corruption, and terrorism, ito po ay mga ongoing wars that will never stop, that government should continue to strengthen. At ang dapat po streamline are mga economic and trade-related offices na magpapahirap sa mga negosyante.
Some senators are meanwhile backing the abolition of the PACC. Senator Coco Pimenta says eliminating the duplication of functions of government agencies is a good decision, which could lead to government savings. For Senator Chiz Escudero, less bureaucracy is always better, so more money can be allotted for projects that directly benefit the Filipino people. Political analyst Tony Lavinia agrees. He points out that the PACC, like other agencies under the Office of the President, is redundant.
I agree actually with that decision because I've always thought ever since that it was just a body to, you know, to just to throw things to whenever there's a scandal. I cannot even recall of any major decisions that that commission has made that made a difference in terms of corruption, to be quite honest.
A pretrial is set for an ill-gotten wealth case filed against Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and his family in 1987. As Adrian Ayalin tells us, it's unclear whether the chief executive will attend the proceedings next month.
The Sandigan Bayan 2nd Division has set the pretrial of President Bongbong Marcos Jr. on August 5 and the pre-marking of evidence on August 4 in the civil case number 0014 involving the ill-gotten wealth of his father, former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Marcos Jr. and other defendants in the case, which includes former First Lady Imelda Marcos, were supposed to start their presentation of evidence after being allowed by the court, even if the case dates back to 1987. In an earlier ruling of the court last month, Marcos Jr. and the other defendants were allowed to present their evidence, stating that courts are in place to adjudicate controversies and it can only be done by going to the very core in order to afford complete relief to all parties involved. Marcos Jr.'s lawyer, Attorney Manuel Plaza, initially asked the court for an extension of 60 days, but Division Chairperson Oscar Herrera said the period is too long.
We asked the court for more time to look at our records. We want to make sure that the witnesses and the evidence that we present in the court will be admissible.
Civil case number 0014 is one of the cases filed against original defendants Imelda and Ferdinand Marcos Sr., which seeks to recover the ill-gotten wealth or assets and properties directly or indirectly acquired through the improper use of funds or properties owned by the government. Other defendants in the case include alleged Marcos cronies Modesto Enriquez, Trinidad Diaz Enriquez, Rebecco Panlilio, Erlinda Enriquez Panlilio, Leandro Enriquez, Don Perry, Roman Cruz Jr., and Gregorio Castillo. The subject corporations in the case include Philippine Village Hotel, Silahis International Hotel, Puerto Azul Beach Club, and the Ternate Development Corporation. While the pre-trial or the submission of final list of pieces of evidence and witnesses should have occurred at the start of trial after the case was filed in 1987, it appeared that Marcos Jr. did not undergo pre-trial proceedings. Asked by the media if Marcos Jr. will be present in the court in the next proceedings, Plaza said it is up to the court to decide.
We'll have to check, no? Because our client is the president, so he has other matters to attend to aside from this one. But we will consult with the court.
Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.